11th standard chapter according to your 11th standard NCERT textbook. Okay. Yeah, my dear, I'm doing good. Thank you. So, I know this is like, you know, like how we have seen human reproduction as one of the important, you know, phenomenon associated with human beings. Even this is one which is associated with us. So here we are talking about the, you know, very important phenomena today. So where you all will become doctors. Jinko doctor banna hai aage jaake. So you will actually understand the difference between, you know, you might have seen this even in movies and all. Koi aise hote hai, jinka kuch to issue ho jata hai health ka, phir bahar operation theater ke bahar sab log khade rehte hai, and they are, you know, expecting ki kuch to achha nahi ho jaye, phir doctor bahar aate aur bolte hai sorry, I can't help it and all, you know, phir wo sab rona dhone ka natak chalu ho jata hai, hai na? तो ये जो सारी आपने मूवीज में जो देखी है ना, वो एग्जैक्टली क्या है बेटा? व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ पर्सन हु इज लिविंग एंड वन फाइन टाइम वी से दैट पर्सन इज नो मोर. सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज गोइंग टू हैपन? यस, इट एग्जैक्टली, सो इट हैपेंस इवन इन रियल लाइफ, आई नो. सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज गोइंग टू बी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दैट पर्टिकुलर ट्रांजिशन मोमेंट, वो जो ट्रांजिशन मोमेंट है लिविंग to non-living or dead, jisko hum keh rahe. What exactly is it? How is oxygen going to play the role in this particular thing? How the oxygen is going to be transported? How the carbon dioxide is going to be transported? Everything we have to understand in details about this particular chapter, which will make our journey very smooth in the coming years to understand the difference between life and death. Okay, it's a very interesting chapter. It's a very beautiful chapter, and we are going to do it in detail. Yeah, beta, what's your doubts? I'll get to your doubts after I complete this particular session. At the end, I'll take your doubts for the earlier chapter. The reason is now I'm connected with the zoology chapter, and your doubts are from botany part. So I'll definitely clear your doubts in the end. I'll clear it. Okay. Yes, of course, that everyone will feel. This unit 5 is associated 11th standard NCERT textbook. If you see unit 5, then you have got all human physiology chapters, right? Unit 5 ka. So this is going to be one of them. Not exactly, I'm just going to combine both the things together, interconnecting them. So this particular chapter, yes, it is going to be of your human physiology, that is breathing and exchange. Okay, and I'll definitely clear your doubts, but I saw your doubts, so I'll just slowly I'll clear it. Okay, there's one question: why some store their food in endosperm while some in cotyledons? Because of single-celled and apna this one. एंडोस्पर्म बहुत कुछ है, बहुत ज्यादा है, बट देर इज यू नो दैट होस्टोरियल और द वेस्टल एक ही है. सो इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी मल्टी, यू नो, 6 to 10 सेल सस्पेंसर नहीं बनता है, एक ही सिंगल वेस्टल रहता है. सो इवन इफ फूड इज देयर, इट कैन नॉट बी रीच टिल दैट पर्टिकुलर. सो दैट इज द रीजन दे स्टोर इन द एंडोस्पर्म ओनली. Second question is, unfertilized ovule has 2 generations, sporophytic and gametophytic, one within the other. So what is sporophytic and gametophytic generation? The one which is going to make spores and the other which is going to make gametes. So here in unfertilized ovule, we have got what? We have got the egg, which is gametophytic, which is a gamete, right? And we have got the nucellus. Nucellus is going to be the sporophytic. So nucellus along with the embryo sac will be the sporophytic and gametophytic generations. Okay. What is the, weren't you there yesterday for the doubt session? Whoever is asking me this, yesterday I've already declared in the doubt sessions, I've already declared the DAT and VAT topics with you all. So exactly. Which chapter is too big to learn? There is nothing called as big and small. Everything is interesting. So I go ahead with today's chapter, beta. That is megaspore is something which is going to be the product of meiosis to form four haploid structures called as the megaspores, out of which three will degenerate. Okay. Got it? And megasporangium is the entire ovule, which will have nucellus along with the embryo sac. Fine. So I'll go now with here you can see the diagram itself is very significant about breathing and exchange of gases. Here you can very clearly see certain important, structures, which of course I'm going to do it in detail. That is going to be your so this is going to be your nasal cavity. Look at it. This is going to be the part which is going to be the nasal cavity. The nostril, right? The oral cavity, the larynx, the right primary bronchus. What is all these things? I'll be dealing it in detail, of course. Here you can see the right lung. This is going to be the pharynx over here. You can see the trachea over here. And this is the left main bronchus. This is the base of the left lung. And here, the red part that you can see below the lungs is going to be the diaphragm. So these are the things that, are going to be done in detail, much in detail, probably much. इसलिए बोल रही बेटा क्योंकि NCERT में भी जितना नहीं है ना उतना हम लोग डिटेल में ये चैप्टर करने वाले हैं. The reason, of course, is as usual, as I keep on saying, that questions have been asked earlier also, and they'll be asked eventually also. Okay, so here, what are the things that we need to see in details? First, the definition. When will be your bio viva? Why are you taking tension of viva right now, beta? Bio viva is done very late after I complete the entire portion. Uske baad viva hoga. Please focus on the current topic, otherwise you will be lost. Don't worry about your vivas, don't worry about your test. Everything will be in place. Right now, give complete 100% attention to this chapter. What is the definition of breathing and exchange? Definition of respiration. See, respiration is the physiological catabolic process in which gaseous exchange occurs to oxidize food. Now, physiological catabolic process, you already know the meaning of this, right? The one which is taking place in every cell is physiological. Catabolic process is breakdown process, correct? So it's going to be leading to the breakdown of food. Okay, we call this as oxidation of food, in which there will be exchange of gases. So which gases are going to exchange? Of course, oxygen and carbon dioxide predominantly. Now, can anyone tell me what is oxidation? How would you define oxidation? There are two ways of defining oxidation. So I want, what exactly is there in your mind? Come on, tell me. What is oxidation, beta? Removal of hydrogen and addition of oxygen. Yes, very correct. Gaining of oxygen, removal of hydrogen. All of you all are right. Yes, my dear, you all are right. Correct. So, in respiration chapter, when we are talking oxidized food, toh humare sabke dimag mein kya aana chahiye? What should be actually, hitting our mind? That there has to be some role of oxygen because we are breathing, na? Right? Yes. So, something is associated with taking in of oxygen and breaking down the food material. But when I'll complete this chapter and a connected chapter with this, okay, that time you will realize the true sense of this particular oxidation of food. Tab tak, yeah, it is breakdown of glucose. Correct. Yes, exactly. So when I'll complete these two chapters, at the end, you will be shocked to know the fact of life. कि आपको लगेगा अरे यार हम कुछ अलग ही सोच रहे थे और ये तो कुछ और ही अलग चल रहा है हमारे बॉडी में. So very important phenomena I'm going to discuss with you all. Okay? So right now जो दिमाग में है वो गलत है ऐसे नहीं बोलूंगी बेटा, but it's much more than that. Fine? The energy generated is utilized as byproducts, that is CO2 and H2O are given out. The energy generated, the word energy itself tells you what, my dears? ATP. So itna to dimag mein aa gaya hamare. What is the thing that has come to our mind, my dears? That whenever some complex molecule is going to be entering our system, it will be broken down in a very systematic way to generate energy, to generate ATP. Okay, so without ATP, nothing is going to happen. Agreed? Without ATP, nothing is going to happen. You won't even be able to move your eyelid. Forget about anything else. And a heartbeat bhi nahi ho sakta hai tumhara agar ATP nahi hai to. So the very important phenomena is what? Generation of ATP. And how will the ATP get generated? By the catabolism of the complex substances, that is food, which would be oxidized to make ATP. Okay? Now, so respiration is a physiochemical process. Physiochemical ka matlab kya hai? There is going to be involving of gaseous of exchange. So it's going to be a physiological process. And why is it chemical? Because ATP is a chemical molecule which is going to be synthesized, which is going to be generated. Okay? So please remember this incorrect statement. They give this respiration is a physiological process alone. Respiration is a chemical process alone. That's a wrong statement. So respiration is a physiochemical process. Okay? The surface at which exchange of gases occurs is called as respiratory surface. And the compounds oxidized in respiration are called as respiratory substrates. Okay. What exactly is this respiratory surface and respiratory substrate? So surface is going to be associated with something called as organs. Hey, yani, to apna respiratory organ kya hai? Exchange sabse zyada jo involved hota hai. What is the organ which is involved? Very good. Of course, it's going to be the lungs, right? Yes. So inside the lungs, whatever the lungs are going to be having the surfaces, that organ ka surface will be called as respiratory surface. But what will be broken down? What will be broken down will be called as respiratory substrate. So basically, what are the respiratory substrates to be broken down to gain energy? Carbohydrates needs to be broken down. Fats needs to be broken down. And proteins need to be broken down. Correct? So we have already seen these things in the living world chapter, that carbohydrates are broken down to sugars, simple sugars, that is glucose, which will then give us ATP. Correct? Fats we saw were broken down into fatty acids and glycerol. Agree? And proteins we saw were broken down into amino acids. Exactly. Very correct, Bita. Yeah, exactly, my dears. So carbohydrates, proteins, fats would together be called as respiratory substrates. So what are respiratory substrates basically? Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, etc., which needs to be broken down. Okay? So you understood the definition, what they're trying to tell you. Any difficulty in understanding this particular 3-4 points which have been mentioned on the board right now? Simple? Yes. Now let us see the types of respiration. Now, when we say types of respiration, na dimag mein aata kya hai? Aerobic and anaerobic. I agree, but there is something more to it. Just see, we have got two types, direct and indirect respiration and aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So we generally think from this point of view, aerobic and anaerobic type, ye hame do type lagte hai, nahi beta. So total agar dekha jaye to 4 hai. Direct ek hai, indirect ek hai, एरोबिक एक है और एनारोबिक एक है, बट दीज आर अपोजिट्स ऑफ ईच अदर ना, इसलिए उनको कपल किया गया है. ओके वी आर गोइंग टू, यस यस ध्रुव यू आर राइट. सो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इट इन डिटेल. सो सी direct and indirect respiration. The first is direct respiration. In this type of respiration, there is direct exchange of gases in between body cells and respiratory medium. Direct exchange of gases between body cells and the respiratory medium surrounding. Okay, exchange of gases on the principle of diffusion through moist body surfaces. Direct respiration is found in unicellular organisms like aerobic bacteria, amoeba, sponge, hydra, flatworms, roundworms, etc. So what happens in them? The outside air and their body surface will directly come in contact with each other. Okay, so they don't have indirect method of delivering or delivery systems nahi hai unke paas to deliver the gases in specific areas. Directly via the moist skin, the exchange would take place. Okay? Frog, yeah, even frogs, exactly. Last point of definition. Okay. No, we don't have. Why do we have? I'll tell you why do we have. The efficiency is going to be different. The surface at which exchange of gases occurs is called as respiratory surface. So the alveoli are going to be the areas in human beings, which is going to be the respiratory surface. And respiratory substrates are those which would be broken down. So carbohydrates, fats, proteins, these all would be broken down. These all will be the respiratory substrate which will yield ATP. Okay. So this is the last point which you wanted me to explain again. Okay. So here what happens in case of direct respiration, the moist surface of the body or the body is going to have surfaces which will directly, help in exchange of gases. They don't have a delivery system. They don't have pipelines. They don't have a complex organization for passing of the gases in a specific way. Okay? Which is going to be in indirect type. So direct type ke examples, yaad rakho beta, they have asked you aerobic bacteria, amoeba, sponges, hydra, flatworm, roundworm. Okay? These all are your invertebrates basically, simple organisms. Right? But in indirect ka example is humans, correct. Indirect are going to be your frog. During winters, they are going to undergo winter sleep. That time, of course, direct respirations. Indirect respiration, in this type of respiration, there is no direct contact in between the body cells and the respiratory medium. Indirect respiration is found in complex and higher forms of organisms. Higher organisms have some specialized structure for gaseous exchange, which are called as respiratory organs. Correct? What is the? Largest going to have direct respiration? It's nothing like that way. So largest wagna nahi hota. It doesn't depend upon the body size. Okay, it doesn't depend upon the body size, but this just depends upon the exchange of gases. Is it via skin, moist skin, by diffusion, or is it via a system like how we have got the respiratory system? So they have given the example. See, skin is the respiratory organ in annelida and amphibians. Annelids are your group of organisms like earthworm, leech, nereus. Okay, these are your annelids. Amphibians, do you know, right? Gills, most of the crustaceans, mollusk, all crustaceans, pata hai na? What are crustaceans? Give me an example of a crustacean. Pata hai aapko ek example koi bhi crustacean ka? Yes, prawns. Prawns are also crustaceans. Shrimp, yes. Shrimp, prawns, these all are going to be your crustaceans. Yes, 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 crabs, yes. Okay, mollusks are going to be, you know what are mollusks? Mollusk ka example pata hai beta? Snails, yes. yes, we call them as snails, correct. All fish and some amphibians. Yes, yes, of course. Yes, yes, you all are right. Yes, yeah. Yes, Dhruv, you are also right. Yes. Amphibians, they all are going to be, you know, having gills. They help in exchange of gases in gills, is called as branchial respiration. So remember this word, which is not given in your NCERT textbook, but they have been asked. Okay. So what is branchial respiration? So respiration with the help of gills is going to be called as branchial respiration. Right. Next is lungs. Lungs is the respiratory organ in snails. Mollusk hai, usme bhi to snails hai. Lungs bhi hai unme. Okay. So depending upon, you know, like they are going to be present in the water bodies also, and they are going to be present on the walls also. So depending upon the habitat, they'll be having adaptation for breathing in both the ways. Okay. Some amphibians also have got lungs. All reptiles have got lungs. Birds have got lungs. And of course, mammals also have got lungs. Yes. Yes. Like slimy. Yeah, they are slimy. Yes. They are slimy. They are going to be present on the walls, na? You might have seen them. They generally crawl on the walls during this rainy season, only you will be able to see them. Sometimes, you know, they come together and they form clusters also. Okay. Then some of the organisms like insects will have their respiration via trachea. Okay. Yes, they crawl on the walls. I know. During this particular, now it's raining since 2 days, you know, it's raining badly. So you can see them. Yes, yes, they cluster under the bricks. Lizard. Lizard is going to be a reptile. Okay. Insects have got only the trachea for respiration. So even these things are not given in your books, my dears. So you need to remember that who are the ones who are having which type of, organs associated with respiration, breathing. Okay. So skin, gills, lungs, trachea. Okay. Any difficulty in this? Tell me. Any difficulty in understanding this indirect respiration? Easy. Can I move ahead? Okay. Then the second type was aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Correct? Now, aerobic respiration, we'll first talk about the aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration, which occurs in presence of oxygen, of course. Okay. So, presence of oxygen is aerobic. The oxygen completely oxidizes the food to CO2 and H2O, releasing large amount of energy. Now, how this is happening? How CO2 and H2O are going to be, released, making energy, is something that we'll be studying, you know, very soon. So today we are just talking about ki haan, oxygen use hota hai, aur CO2 or H2O byproducts bante hai, and ATP release hoti hai. This is a statement that I'm doing right now. But I'll prove this statement in the, coming days. I'll prove this to you all that how it is used and how this is going to be made. Okay. My dear, please pay attention. I've already said annelids are your earthworms, leech, nereus and all. Okay. This process can be shown by the following way. Now here, this way. These arrows could not get printed in this format. Anyways, so C6H12O6. What is C6H12O6? Kiska formula hai? Chalo batao, fatafat. What is this? I hope you all know this. Yeah, you all are right. All are right. It's glucose, correct? So C6H12O6 plus 6 CO2 will give us, this arrow is like this way, huh? So the arrow will give us 6 CO2 plus 6H2O plus 2880 kilojoules. Ye kya hai? What is the full form of this? Okay. Kilojoules kehte hum log. How we say kgs, grams, how we say na? Like that way. Kj stands for kilojoules. Okay. Yeah, see. So much of energy is going to be made. So much of energy is liberated. by one molecule of glucose. So what is this? This is our glucose. Okay. This is 6CO2. Yes. 6CO2. Yes. Okay. So in this way, glucose is going to be oxidized. See, now here they are saying, what is that? 6O2. So oxidize होने के लिए oxygen चाहिए, ऐसा हमें जो लग रहा था वो यहाँ पर उन्होंने final reaction में दिया है. I'll prove this also how it is right. Okay. Such type of respiration is found in most animals and plants. So even plants respire. ऐसा नहीं है कि they will only take in CO2. They'll release CO2 also at the time of respiration. Fine. So that is the reaction that you have to remember. That is glucose plus oxygen will give us carbon dioxide plus water and energy. Okay. Got it? Any difficulty? Any difficulty? I'll move ahead. So, KJ stands for kilo joules. So, bacha, ye yaad rakhna. Now we go to phases of aerobic respiration. Okay, what are the phases? There are two phases of aerobic respiration: external respiration and internal respiration. External respiration is also called as breathing or ventilation. External means external area. That's going to be, like whatever. It could be in case of aquatic animals, it's going to be water. Right, in our case, it's going to be the atmosphere, right? There's going to be exchange of gases from outside to inside our body and inside our body to outside our body, right? So that is going to be the external respiration, which is going to be called as breathing. So my dears, breathing and respiration are not the same. Breathing is a part of respiration. Did you all get this? Breathing is going to be just a part of respiration. So respiration on and on, it's a very huge process. It's a very large process that we have to understand, out of which today we are going to only understand breathing and exchange of gases. We are not going to learn about anything about respiration today, matlab in this chapter. So aaj ke hamara jo humne aaj jo chapter start kiya na beta, it's only associated with external respiration, that is breathing. Internal respiration uske agla wala chapter rahega. Because I need to connect the two things now, only then you will understand. Halfway छोड़ दूँ तो क्या मजा आएगा फिर? तो आज मैंने जो start किया है topic, उसमें हम लोग क्या देखेंगे? External respiration देखेंगे. And eventually a part of internal respiration हमें इस chapter में देखना है. But major part जो है, that will be seen in next chapter, that is respiration on a whole, large picture. Anyways, so external respiration is also called as breathing or ventilation. It is gaseous exchange between the respiratory organs and the outer environment. Example, exchange of gases between lungs and air. So this is very simple. What is external respiration? Internal respiration. See, internal respiration is also called as tissue respiration. It is the exchange of oxygen of blood and carbon dioxide of the body cells through tissue fluid at the cellular level. Okay. So here in this chapter, the second point is also going to be considered. I'll be talking about the second point also. So I said partially. So it is the exchange of oxygen with whom? With whom? With the tissues. Via whom? Via the system called as circulatory system. Blood. Via the blood. Okay. So technically speaking, पता है आपको जो अपना blood होता है ना, it's only going to act like a vehicle. वो सिर्फ एक vehicle के जैसे act करता है. It is going to bring oxygen. It will deposit oxygen at the tissue level, and it will carry carbon dioxide from the tissue level and bring it to the lungs for throwing it out. Okay? तो इट्स राउंड द क्लॉक सर्विस. आपके पास राउंड सर्विस के बसेस देखे आपने? हैव यू ऑल सीन राउंड द क्लॉक सर्विस होते हैं बसेस. दे स्टार्ट फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए, दे गो टू बी सी डी एफ जेड एंड अगेन कम बैक टू ए. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज राउंड सर्विस. So our blood is like that way. And what happens, see, even you can take the example of our bus or trains also, there would be few people who get down at different destinations. So suppose there are, like, they have boarded the train from Borivali. Some want to get down at Goregaon, some want to get down at Villeparle, some want to get down at Andheri, some want to get down at Churchgate. Correct, na? So some will get down at that particular places, but consequently, there are people who will enter the train or the bus at the same time. So there are someone who would be entering into the bus and or the train, and if there are seats available, they'll go and occupy those seats. So it's exactly like that way. Our blood is just acting like a vehicle. It's only going to help in carrying the oxygen from the lungs to the tissue, and it will also carry the carbon dioxide from the tissue to the lungs. Exchange offer. Yeah, it acts like a postman. Exactly. Okay. So this is what we are going to talk about in this chapter, of course. Then cellular level करके एक word आया है देखो. So exchange of oxygen of the blood and carbon dioxide of body cells through tissue fluid at cellular level. So cellular level means at the tissue के cell के level में. अब मुझे एक बताओ बेटा, tissue के पास CO2 कहाँ से आया? Who made that CO2 to, you know, come in the tissue? No. It's not the blood. Cells of the tissue. Yes, correct. It is the cells of the tissue. Cells of the tissue ke paas CO2 kahan se aaya? No, not the tissue fluid. Tissue fluid is also a medium only. Very good, Vaishnavi. Yes, 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 yes. So it's going to be from the glucose or fats that we have consumed. So whatever is the respiratory substrate, it will be broken down. And to generate energy, what is the aim of breaking down that particular substrate? To gain energy. So when the energy is going to be made, that time byproducts are going to be released, and the byproduct is going to be CO2. So the cells at the time of breaking down the complex substances, what will happen? They will break down the complex substances with an intention of making ATP. But during the making of ATP, ye free gift milta hai hume. What is that free gift? CO2 and water. We don't want both of them. Okay. So ye CO2 to, if it remains in our body, na, it is not going to be accepted. So it needs to be transported back out of our body. And along with that, even the, you know, this particular water is called as metabolic water, a product of metabolism. So even that needs to be thrown out. Have you all, you all know I wear specs. Okay. So if I take the specs and I just breathe out from my nose also on the specs, kya ho jayega beta? What will happen? Water vapor. Exactly. It becomes foggy. Yes. So that fogginess or that water vapor jo aaya hai na, kahan se aaya? From my nostril, from my nose. Right? How? The metabolic water is released. We don't realize that we are throwing out this metabolic water in the form of water vapor. But when you use specs and when you, you know, like breathe over it, you can immediately get that fog. Right? I know, whenever we wear the mask, na, ye fog bahut pareshan karta hai. Why the cell doesn't? It's a waste product. It's a metabolic waste that needs to be thrown out. Anything that is a waste needs to be thrown out. I know, even I wear mask, so what do? You know, I generally wear that mask in such a way and I put my specs over it. Fir fog nahi aayega. Try it out. But it's very irritating, I know. Respiration can take place through mouth too. What is the difficulty if it's going to pass through the mouth, if the air is going to be passing through the mouth? Sometimes you do na, agar aapka nostril clogged hai, blocked hai, to raat mein na aapka muh khulla rehta hai. Right? Yeah, while sleeping. I know. Yeah, that time, yes. So that time, yes, Vedant, you are right, yes. हाँ वेरी गुड पलक, यू आर राइट माय डियर. सो व्हाट हैपेंस बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ना, पाथवे उसका गेट, उसका एंट्री पॉइंट ही चेंज हो जाता है, उसका एंट्री पॉइंट ही चेंज हो जाता है, देन दैट विल लीड टू यू नो समवॉट डिफिकल्टी इवेंचुअली. सो टू चैप्टर्स वी हैव टू स्टडी ना, ब्रीदिंग एंड एक्सचेंज एंड दिस थिंग अपना डाइजेशन वाला चैप्टर. सो व्हेन वी कंबाइन दीज टू फैक्ट्स टूगेदर ना, यू विल बी शॉक्ड एंड एस्टोनिश्ड टू नो मेनी थिंग्स लाइक यू नो यू माइट हैव नेवर थॉट ऑफ. ओके, सो वी डू ब्रीथ विद आवर माउथ ऑल्सो समटाइम्स, बट इट्स नॉट अ गुड थिंग, इट्स नॉट अ गुड थिंग. और इसीलिए पता है आपको, आई डोंट नो, मतलब बोला जाता है कि जब हम खाना खाते हैं ना, तो वी शुड नॉट स्पीक एंड यू शुड कीप योर माउथ क्लोज एंड यू शुड च्यू योर फूड. अदरवाइज अलॉन्ग विद द फूड बात करते रहोगे ब्ला 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 ब्ला, तो यू आर गोइंग टू टेक मच ऑफ यू नो एयर ऑल्सो इन साइड. आई टेल यू वाई इज इट नॉट गुड, आई टेल यू, आई डेफिनेटली टेल यू. हाँ, सेलुलर लेवल इज द मोस्ट बेसिक लेवल, येस माई डियर, दैट इज विद इन द सेल वॉट इज गोइंग टू हैपन. ओके, हाँ गॉट इट ना. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी योर यू नो सेलुलर लेवल पे जो होता है, तो इन द सेल द सबस्ट्रेट विल बी ब्रोकन डाउन, CO2 will be liberated. Now all the cells will liberate CO2, will be collectively formed in the tissue. So tissue में waiting में है अभी CO2. CO2 is in the waiting, it's in the queue कि कब अपना blood आएगा वहां पर, कब oxygen यहाँ पर deposit करेगा, और oxygen deposit करने के बाद जब वो seat खाली हो जाएगी blood के अंदर की, मतलब hemoglobin की, तब जाके CO2 कब उधर जाके बैठेगा. So it's you know like everything is a very synchronized process, a very beautiful process. Okay, it involves cellular respiration in which glucose is oxidized inside the mitochondria of the cell to produce water and carbon dioxide along with energy. So this third point which is given over here na beta, ye jo third point yahan par hai, ye jo third point yahan par hai na, ye third point ko फिलहाल के लिए किधर गया, ये थर्ड पॉइंट को फिलहाल के लिए मैं सर्कल करके रखती हूँ, बिकॉज ये थर्ड पॉइंट विल बी कवर्ड इन दिस चैप्टर. दिस थर्ड पॉइंट विल बी कवर्ड इन द चैप्टर कॉल्ड एज रेस्पिरेशन. ओके फाइन, बट यस आफ्टर आई कंप्लीट दिस चैप्टर, दिस थर्ड पॉइंट वाला चैप्टर अपना स्टार्ट हो जाएगा. But remember that internal respiration is going to involve three stages, which is the first one. Respiration will involve two stages, external and internal. External exchange of gases with the respiratory surfaces. Internal will have two things, tissue and blood ke beech mein exchange of it. And second thing, cell ke andar kya ho raha hai, kya kya byproducts kaise ban rahe hai, and how they are you know eventually transported to the blood is something with respect to cellular respiration. Okay, any doubts, any confusion in this particular thing? Oh my god, what are respiratory surfaces again? Respiratory surfaces in human beings is going to be the lungs, fish and amphibians could be gills, skin in case of certain amphibians, trachea in case of insects. Okay, so they are going to have areas, jaise ki lungs will have alveoli, which is going to be the respiratory surface, right? Okay, good. So any difficulty in this? Come on, come on, tell me my dears, any difficulty, any doubt? We'll go ahead to, what is that two? Second point, which is the second point here? In internal respiration, you can point to be explained. Nothing, beta. The oxygen will be carried via the blood and will be deposited in the tissue cells or the body cells. The carbon dioxide in the body cells will be picked up by the same blood and brought to the lungs for throwing it out of the body. Okay, so it is the exchange of oxygen of the blood, means now the oxygen got inside the blood and the carbon dioxide is going to be present in the body cells through tissue fluid. Yeah, so there is going to be, you know, we have seen lymph. So lymph ka jo tissue fluid hai na, it's going to be acting as a medium for exchange. Without tissue fluid, exchange nahi hota hai. Okay, so it requires tissue fluid via which this transport is going to be possible. Got it? Fine? Yeah. Then we talk about the क्या हो गया यहाँ पर, ये बराबर से नहीं आया. Blood travels to the body and comes back. Yes, I do. Respiration which occurs in the absence of oxygen is called as anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration is also called as fermentation. So, I guess you all are aware of this word fermentation. What is that? Idli, dosa, dhokla, kuch bhi banana hai to usko ferment karne ke liye rakhna padta hai na? Correct? Yes, exactly. So, मस्त लगा ना ये सब नाम सुन के, इडली डोसा ढोकला. मस्त बारिश भी हो रही है, गर्मा गर्म ये सारी चीजें आपके सामने आएगी तो और मजा आएगा, है ना. यू नो व्हाट इज फर्मेंटेशन. सो फर्मेंटेशन के लिए यू रिक्वायर व्हाट, एनरोबिक कंडीशन. सो इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ एनरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. इट इज फाउंड इन बैक्टीरिया, ईस्ट एंड पैरासिटिक वर्म्स. व्हाट आर पैरासिटिक वर्म्स? यू नो व्हाट आर पैरासिटिक वर्म्स? कैन यू ऑल टेल मी? कभी हुए है किसी को पैरासिटिक वर्म्स ने परेशान किया है कभी? राउंड वर्म्स, या द वंस व्हिच आर आल्सो प्रेजेंट इन आर, दे आर आल्सो प्रेजेंट इन आर बॉडी. हां, पता है आपको एस्कैरिस? पता है आपको एस्कैरिस आर द वर्म्स व्हिच आर देयर इन आर इंटेस्टाइन. बिकॉज़ अ लॉट ऑफ यू नो क्रैम्प्स इन आर इंटेस्टाइन समटाइम्स. So, yeah, they are going to be the parasitic worms. They all are going to have this fermentation one thing. Not necessary always. Tapeworm, yes. Tapeworm is because of consumption of pork. I agree. But ascaris jo hai na, mitti mein kheloge aur wo muh mein haath jayega na, ascaris chalu ho jayega. Anyways, so in this type of respiration, food is partially oxidized. Partially means not completely oxidized. Okay, so the end product of aerobic respiration is water and carbon dioxide and energy, correct? But here the food is not going to reach up to the level of complete oxidation, fine? So it's going to be partially oxidized. It can be shown in the following way. C6, again, I'll draw the arrows over here and I'll make the things, you know, a bit simple. Ye aise kyun aaya mujhe nahi pata. Anyways, so ye dekho, this is the arrow. C6H12O6, okay, will, it's going to like, this is going to be in the intestinal worms, aise likha hai. So this, they are talking about where it is taking place. So it can take place in the intestinal worms, okay, to form what? C, okay, to form lactic acid. What is the formula of lactic acid? C, CH3CHOH COOH. By now you surely know केमिस्ट्री में आपने ये डेफिनेटली किया होगा कि COOH अगर आता है तो इट्स गोइंग टू बी एसिड, राइट? इट्स गोइंग टू बी एसिड एंड CH3CHOH इज गोइंग टू बी फॉर योर लैक्टिक एसिड. सो दिस लैक्टिक एसिड व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इनसाइड द इंटेस्टाइन ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइनल वर्म्स इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फर्मेंटेशन. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ हैविंग वॉटर एंड CO2, वॉट वी हैव, we have got lactic acid and energy. Okay, samajh mein aa gaya? To aerobic respiration ka by product kya hai beta? What is the aerobic respiration ka by product? CO2 H2O, energy. What is the fermentation ka by product? Lactic acid and energy. So your CO2 is not going to be formed, either water is going to be formed. Okay, yeah, my dear. Yes, in some alcohol is formed, right? Like yeah. Even alcohols are, you know, all alcohols, ethyl alcohol specifically, is a product of fermentation. Agreed. Correct? Aerobic respiration gives more energy. Of course, aerobic respiration gives us 38 ATP, while anaerobic respiration gives us only 2 ATP. So 36 ATP zyada milta hai hame aerobic respirations. Okay? This is a very important phenomena. You might have experienced this, which is given as a note over there. Anaerobic respiration even takes place in certain parts of our body tissues. So, a particular area of the apne body mein bhi ye hota hai. Yes, muscles. We call it as muscle fatigue, tiredness of the muscles, right? Example, in the skeletal fiber, muscle fibers, in mammalian RBCs, in skeletal muscle fibers during vigorous exercise, glucose is metabolized into lactic acid instead of getting, metabolized into CO2 and water. So, vigorous exercise agar karte hain, over exertion, strenuous exercise karte hain na, to cramps aate hain, dekho. You might have, I don't know if you have experienced this cramps or not, but these cramps are very deadly. They're actually very deadly. Matlab, hare, bohat, aur wo rahat ke time pe aata hai, re. Matlab, very much in the night now, all of a sudden you will get a cramp and you don't know what to do. You cannot, tum chilla nahi sakte ho. Everyone is sleeping. You can't sit. You can't stand. You can't sleep. You can't dance. You can't do anything. It gives a very bad pain, right? I mean, you are helpless. You don't understand what is to be done at that particular time. That type of cramps are going to be, experienced. Horrible, horrible. Yeah, it is very horrible. Statue in one position. Yeah, exactly. And especially, now to these online lectures were going on for almost 1.5 year plus. But when it is to be physical lectures, na, to 8 to 10 hours of rigorous teaching. And I have to stand and I have to teach. Obviously, I can't sit and teach when I'm teaching on the board. Right. So 8 to 10 hours ka khada rehne ke baad, raat mein jab sote the na, oh, that is the best time to get the cramps. Khatarnak wale cramps aate hain. How to know you're experiencing cramps? That pain itself will tell you that it is a cramp. In middle of the night, you will get it. What has to be done in such a case? Stand and ensure that particular part will get maximum blood supply. So you have to, actually bang your leg if it's in the leg or, especially during, if you're going to be a sports person, you get cramps in your shoulder region or in your elbow region. So it should be ensured that they get maximum blood supply. Okay. Yeah, it has to be banged till it, it has to, that is the only way. You have to restore the blood supply over there. Okay. So that is what happens in our certain parts of the body. That is not good. That is not good, in fact. Yeah, gymming karne ke baad bhi hota hai, yes. The rapid formation and accumulation of lactic acid are responsible for this muscle fatigue. In mammalian RBCs, anaerobic respiration is found because no mitochondria is found in mammalian RBCs. So sometimes this mammalian RBCs, RBCs don't have mitochondria. Okay. So they'll undergo this type of muscle, fatigue, that is development of lactic acid over there. Okay. Move and all when you spray, it is a sprain. If it's your leg has sprained, it has got twisted, then that type of pain is a sprain. Okay. But this is a cramp. क्रैम्प कुछ किए बगैर ऐसे ही रात में तुम लोग सोए रहेंगे ना तो ऑल ऑफ अ सडन वो कहीं ना कहीं ऐसे ये पेन चालू हो जाएगा. इट विल बी फॉर फ्यू सेकंड्स टू लाइक फ्यू मिनट्स. इट विल सबसाइड इवेंचुअली. अपने आप आ जाता है. यस, क्रैम्प्स अपने आप आ जाते हैं. ओके, आई टेल यू व्हाट आर स्पैज़म्स इन द चैप्टर ऑफ लोकोमोशन. देयर आर ऑल दीस टाइप्स, ट्विच, स्पैज़म्स, क्रैम्प्स, sprain, strain, all have to be defined. So in locomotion chapter, definitely I'll be talking in detail about all these. Okay. Anyway, so here we are only concerned with the cramps that are developed due to the accumulation of lactic acid. Nahi. Mungyayana is not cramp. That is numbness. That is numbness. N-U-M-B, numbness. Okay. Well, so yeah, that is about the anaerobic respiration. Then we directly come to something called as mammalian respiratory system. Technically, yeah, the process of respiration begins from here. Mammalian respiratory system is formed of following parts. So here you can see this. nostril. You can see the nostril over here. Yeah, so jahan nose hai, yahan se jo opening hai, this will be the nostril. Nasal chamber, the pathway of the nose is the nasal chamber. Internal nerves, nerves are the openings. Then you can see the pharynx over here. See, you can see this is the pharynx. Laryngopharynx, it lies between larynx and pharynx wala region. That is called as laryngopharynx. Then you can see over here, this is the larynx. Okay. The vocal cord, due to which we are capable of making sounds. Right? Trachea. You can see the trachea over here very clearly. Right? This is the trachea. Primary bronchi. So this one main unit is going to be the primary bronchi, left and right. Okay, just from bronchus bol rahe hai, primary bronchi. Lungs, of course. You can see the lungs, right lung, left lung. Correct? So that is going to be the main, very important parts. Okay. Frontal sinus. Sinus is going to be the gaps. Nasal conchae. Conchae are going to be the ridges. If you touch your nose, you can see 1, 2, and 3 ridges coming together like a cone. Okay. And yeah, the rest of the things I've already shown. In this, food part and water part is divided. Food part and water part nahi hota hai, beta. Food and water alag nahi hota hai. Air and ye alag hota hai. Food. Okay. Yeah. So that's about the ten important labels. Okay. I'll tell you in detail. Now each one will be done in detail. Frontal sinus is going to be this particular area. Yahan par the apical part of this. Jahan par hum log hamara chashma rakhte hai na, that part. Okay. Esophagus is a part of digestive system and not of the respiratory system. So it won't be considered over here. Well, first we talk about the nostril. Huh. Sinus due to sneezing or cold? Nahin. That is actually a wrong word. Sinus ka matlab kya hota hai? Sinus ka matlab hota hai cavity. And when the cavity get blocked because of cold, we say that this person is suffering from sinus. So actually sinus is what? Cavities. Okay. So first we come across the word called as nostril. It is also called as external nare. Okay, so what is the other name of nostril? External nare. So you know what is nostrils, right? The two openings at the front of our, you know, nose. It's an oval aperture of nose present at the lower end. So nose ka ye lower end hai beta, ye jo broad hai na, ye lower end hai. Okay, presence of two nerves is called as dyrhinus stage. Dy means two, rhinus means nose. Rhinitis is common cold. Okay, so dyrhinus stage means having two nerves, right? Then we come across with another word called as nasal chamber. So nasal septum divides nasal cavity into two nasal chambers by the nasal septum. Okay, so it divides the nasal cavity. So ye do nostrils ke beech mein ek patla sa cartilage jata hai, dekho. You can move the tip of your nose because of the presence of this cartilage, right? So this particular, you know, ye jo parde ke jaisa hai, a cartilage present till the, you know, upper region of our nose entire is going to be the nasal chamber. It's divided into two because of this nasal septum. Each nasal septum can be divided into three regions. These three parts are as follows. First, the vestibular part. Now this is what this entire ये जो cones दिखते हैं ना हमारे nose के अंदर के ये जो cones हैं ना उनकी बातें हो रही हैं. So they are going to be of three parts: vestibular, respiratory, and olfactory. Vestibular means, you know what is a vestibule, right? In human reproduction also we have done this word vestibule. It is smaller and anterior part, and it is lined by hairy skin which acts as a filter and prevents entry of dust particles. So vestibule means hollow cavity. So this two nasal chambers ka ye jo outer side jo hai, anterior part jo hai, it's going to have hair, correct? Now this hair is going to act like filter to prevent the dust particles from entering. So jahan tak ye hair present hai na, that part will be your vestibular. Now please don't put your fingers in your nose and try to test it ki kidhar tak hai. Yeah, it's a very bad habit. Okay, don't do that. I know. Hey, even in the physical lectures when I teach this na, there are so many students who will check kahan tak wo hairy part hai karke. Mam idhar tak vestibule. Are it's okay. I mean, I have not asked you till where it is and all here. So please don't do that. Huh? Don't put your fingers in your nose. Yeah, so that is the vestibular part. So you understood what is the vestibular part. Okay. Second is the respiratory part. So in the middle part, it is the middle part and is lined by pseudostratified epithelium. So there is a chapter called as structural organization in animals, wherein I'll be talking about the different types of tissues. Okay, human beings mein kya kya tissues hai, to usme ek pseudo stratified epithelium hota hai. I'll just quickly tell you within a minute that what is this pseudo stratified epithelium. Okay, so yeah, you can see this black screen now. I hope you all can see this black screen. Okay, now if I have to draw, sorry, why not, if I have to draw अपना सिंपल एपिथेलियम, तो इट इज गोइंग टू बी समथिंग लाइक दिस वे. ओके, सो इट्स गोइंग टू बी मेड अप ऑफ सिंपल सच टाइप ऑफ सेल्स. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी व्हाट, अ सिंगल लेयर ऑफ सेल्स हेल्ड टुगेदर. ऑफ कोर्स ईच विल हैव अ न्यूक्लियस. This is going to be your simple epithelium. Okay, इसको हम क्या कहते हैं, simple simple epithelium. Okay, yeah, generally you have this in your 9th standard, but still I'm just giving you a recap. Okay, this is your simple epithelium. What will happen in stratified epithelium? So in stratified epithelium na, you will have one layer above the other, making tall, you know, tissue. Tall banta hai ye, ek ke upar ek, ek ke upar ek, okay hai na? So it will appear something like this way. So it's going to be a multi-layered tissue. Okay, so you have got so many layers one above the other. See, just like how a well looks like. So it's going to be your stratified epithelium. Okay, so this is going to be the stratified epithelium, brick wall. Yeah, so you can see there are so many, you know, multicellular and tall, ek ke upar ek rache hue ye, aise dikhenge. That is going to be your stratified epithelium. Stacked one above the other. Okay, अब इन दोनों के बीच में आएगा अपना pseudo stratified. I'll show you what is pseudo stratified now. Okay, so here you know there's going to be something like this. The cells are going to be something like this. Can you see what has happened? So it is actually not sitting one above the other. बट दे आर ओनली वन ओनली वन लेयर ओनली बट उनका हाइट देखो, कोई लंबे है, कोई छोटे है, कोई आड़े है, कोई तेरे है, इट्स सिंगल लाइन बट दे अपीयर टू बी स्ट्रेटिफाइड, देयरफॉर वी कॉल देम एज स्यूडो स्ट्रेटिफाइड. अंडरस्टूड ना? सो दे आर एक्चुअली नॉट गोइंग टू बी इन लेयर्स, दे अपीयर टू बी इन लेयर्स जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ देयर डिफरेंट साइजेस, टॉल एंड शॉर्ट, इररेगुलर प्लेसमेंट्स. ओके, सो दे अपीयर एज tall, I mean multi-layered, but they aren't. So this particular one that we're talking about right now is the pseudo-stratified. Understood what is pseudo-stratified? Okay. So this is what we're talking about. Where are we? Pseudo-stratified epithelium. Okay. So it is the middle part which is lined with the pseudo stratified epithelium which acts as air conditioner. Ab air conditioner matlab apna AC nahi hai. To condition the air means to warm up the air. So before the air enters our system, it needs to be warmed. It needs to be made almost in equilibrium with our body temperature. So that particular warming up the air before it enters our system is going to be the, you know, responsibility of the respiratory part of the nasal chamber. Okay, it brings the inspired air at the body temperature. So you know, like during winters when the external air is really going to be cold, and when we try to take in, then you know it needs to be actually warmed up to bring it to our body temperature. So that is the role of respiratory part. Okay, third is the olfactory part. Olfaction means smell. What do you mean by the word olfaction? Smell. So it is the upper part of the nasal chamber. So this almost the cone of our nose, okay? So it's the upper part of the nasal chamber and it is lined by olfactory epithelium called as Cnidarian membrane. CH jo hai na, wo silent hai. So it is called as what? Cnidarian membrane, okay? It looks yellowish brown. This region acts as an organ of smell. Okay, so three bony ridges, the superior, middle, and the inferior nasal conchae arises from the wall of this nasal chamber. The nasal conchae increases the surface area of the nasal chamber for better air conditioning. So, ye nasal conchae idhar niche aate, dekho. Touch your nose sideways. Try to touch it sideways. You can see bony structures on both the sides and this at the center also. At the center also, तो ये एक दो और ये तीन है ना, इसको हम nasal conchae कहते हैं बेटा. They originate from this upper part and they come towards the respiratory part. Okay, so superior is going to be the uppermost. This is the middle and this is the nasal inferior one. So in this way ना, you have got three ridges. Ridges means projections. Okay. Which is going to be called as your nasal conchae. This increases the surface area as well as it is also going to help in conditioning the air before it enters into our system. So this is all about the nasal chamber. Any difficulty in understanding nasal chamber? Vestibular part, respiratory part, and olfactory part. Go through it. Go through it. फटाफट कुछ है difficulty तो पूछो. आगे के diagram में ना nasal chamber और clearly दिखेंगे भी तुम्हें. Why it has to be warm? If it is not going to be warmed up, what will happen? It's going to lead to an inequilibrium will be set in, and it will, you know, cause the pressures of the gases to alter. So oxygen ka pressure ek maintain hona chahiye. It needs to be warmed up. Superior, middle, and inferior. Superior is would be towards the forehead side. Okay, middle would be towards the side, and inferior is would be making the you know, combined part at the base. So like that way we have got three diagram that I drew. Okay, I hope it's there. Oh, it went. I didn't save it. Okay. You will get this. I'll draw these diagrams again in the chapter of structural organization. Don't worry. Right? Don't forget the word nidarian membrane, beta. It is the membrane which gives us the sense of smell. Okay? Can I move ahead? Have you all understood till here? Any difficulty? So here you can very well see. Can you see over here? One, two, and the three. Ye dekho. One, two, and the three. These are going to be your nasal conchae. That's what I said. In the next diagram, you will be able to see them very clearly. So, ye dekho, ye ek hai nasal conchae, superior wala. Ye side se hai, that is the middle. Aur ye inferior wala hai, which is going to form the base of it. Have understood na? Then we go to the internal nares. These are the posterior openings of the nasal chamber that leads to nasopharynx. Posterior means jaise yahan par two openings nostril ke hai na, external nares ke hai na, waise udhar upar jaane ke baad again the two pores will remain as small pores only. Those will be smaller in size, of course, projecting towards the forehead side. So that upper part will be called as your internal nares or internal openings. Theek hai? Then we have got the pharynx. Pharynx comprises of nasopharynx, oropharynx, and laryngopharynx. The pharynx provides passage for both air as well as food. My dears, please pay attention to this. This is a very important point. It becomes like, you know, many a times these things confuse you so much. So please understand. Here you can see this is the entire part. This red plus this brown plus this green. Okay, ye wala, light green. Everything is a part of your pharynx only. Okay, now here they are saying nasopharynx. Now here you can very well see that whatever, you know, air will be taken in is going to ultimately enter over here. Okay, but it is, this pharynx is near which region? It's near the nasal region. So this region will be called as nasopharynx. Okay, see here. See here. Fine. Then here, actually, ये जो है ना ये इधर तक आना चाहिए बेटा. ये वाला जो part है. This is going to be the oropharynx, which is associated with what? ये देखो. Mouth region. Mouth के यहाँ पर है. इसलिए इसको हम कहते हैं oropharynx. And look at this one. This is near the larynx. This is near the larynx. So this is going to be called as laryngopharynx. Okay. That is going to be the this thing, larynx ka part beta. Adam's apple is associated with larynx, not with pharynx. So pharynx se kya ho raha hai dekho, nasopharynx se air andar aa rahi hai, oropharynx se food andar aa raha hai, and dono jo hai ultimately jaane wale hamare esophagus mein food chala jayega, and larynx ke via hamara air लंग्स में चला जाएगा, राइट ना, करेक्ट. सो इन दिस वे या लंग्स वाई दैट ट्रिकी ऑफ कोर्स. सो ये जो है ना बेटा, यहाँ पर जो है इट नीड्स टू बी, यू नो, अ सिस्टम हैज टू बी प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर टू कंट्रोल द एंट्री ऑफ द फूड. कभी कभी हमें फूड खाते खाते एकदम से बोलते हैं ना, किसी ने याद किए तुम्हारी, है ना, पीपल से लाइक दैट वे ना, यू फील लाइक चोकिंग. या यू फील लाइक चोकिंग. Why it has happened like that way? You try this thing. Come on, you try this thing. When you take in water, forget about food. Yeah, exactly. When you take in water, na beta, not even food. Main food ki baat nahi kar rahi. That time when you are actually swallowing the water, do you breathe? Can you breathe when you are drinking a sip of water? Try doing it. Exactly. Never you can do this. Yes, food goes into the food pipe. Correct. Trachea is the windpipe and esophagus is the food pipe. Okay. Fine. Now it is also not called as larynx or pharynx. Fine. You try this. You might have never ever, you know, experience this, but you can definitely try this. Do you carry a bottle like me when you sit for the lectures? मैं देखो तुमने देखा होगा मैं कितनी बार पानी पीती रहती हूँ तुम्हें बोलते बोलते खत्म होने को आया मेरे पानी की है ना unless and until you don't gulp it down ना you can't breathe in you tried ना exactly so why is it like that way what happens so it happens because of accidentally if it goes into the windpipe ना बाप रे बाप जान चली जाती है यू ट्राई इट यू शुड ट्राई दैट इज व्हाट इज आवर यू नो लाइक बायो ऑल अबाउट द एक्चुअल थिंग्स दैट वी कैन एक्सपीरियंस राइट एग्जैक्टली हाँ तो हालत खराब होती है बाबा इतना वो सफोकेशन के जैसा हो जाता है ना लाइक यू कांट ब्रीद इन आई नो सो दिस इज व्हाट इज एंड यू सी वी हैव गॉट एन इमीडिएट रिफ्लेक्स कुछ ऐसे अटक जाता है ना तो वी स्टार्ट कॉफिंग सो यू नो इट्स गोइंग टू थ्रो आउट ऑल द पार्टिकल्स फूड पार्टिकल्स और वाटर पार्टिकल्स फ्रॉम द नोज होता है कि नहीं कभी कुछ अटक जाता है इट इज गोइंग टू बी यू नो कमिंग आउट बाय द नोज ऑल्सो वाई यू अंडरस्टूड नाउ बिकॉज दिस इज अ कॉमन पाथवे बेटा फैरिंग्स इज अ कॉमन पाथवे तो इट कैन बी यू नो लाइक इट्स गोइंग टू बी प्रोपेल्ड अपवर्ड्स उसको ऊपर फेंका जाएगा तो ऊपर जाएगा तो वो सबसे पहले तो ये नेसोफैरिंक्स में जाएगा एंड थ्रू द नोज इट कम्स आउट हाँ या ऑफ कोर्स इट हैपेंस यू गेट द फीलिंग ऑफ यू नो वॉमिटिंग वाला सेंसेशन भी आता है नोजियारिक फीलिंग दिस इज दिस नोज में से आता है ना इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस ड्राउनिंग यू वी कैन फील इट यस happened due to pressure it happens due to this epiglottis so this is going to be epiglottis which I'm talking about in the laryngopharynx region see laryngopharynx is the lower part of the pharynx and it has a slit like aperture called as glottis slit like aperture slit means what ek opening hai aperture hai na so this slit like aperture would be called as glottis which can be closed by a leaf like bilobed cartilage called as epiglottis during swallowing of food so what happens this epiglottis is going to cover this epiglottis is going to cover the glottis and prevent the mixing of food and air okay so this is because of epiglottis agar by mistake food windpipe mein chala gaya to epiglottis kya karega wo flap hai wo hai na usko piche upar aise fek dega dhakel dega chal hat idhar nahi aane ka तो वो जो चल हट करता है ना तभी हम लोग कॉफिंग करने लगते हैं या एग्जैक्टली यस भूमि ओके बट दिस इज मूवेबल इट्स लाइक अ फ्लिपिंग मूवमेंट ओके नॉर्मल केस में है ना इट्स गोइंग टू कीप दैट पर्टिकुलर ग्लॉटिस ओपन ओनली ओके वो स्लिट ओपन रहेगा बट व्हेनेवर वी आर गोइंग टू ईट फूड ना तो ये ऐसे ऊपर चला जाता है सो दैट फूड विल एंटर अंडरस्टूड हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू बी नॉर्मली इट्स ओपन Because we don't eat 24/7, we breathe 24/7. Okay, so it is going to be normally open like this, and from this end, when we gulp the food, na it will be pushed up, and food pipe mein food will go. One way movement. Yes, it's one way movement. Exactly, like a hinge joint. Okay, opening only in one direction. Fine. So please remember, beta, where what is the location of this glottis? Laryngopharynx. So. That is going to be, you know, the area which will have glottis and epiglottis. How our body throws out that food through coughing. It's a reflex action. That's what I said, my dear. That this epiglottis will, you know, propel it outward. Nahi chahiye, ja aage. Go out. So as and when the epiglottis will, you know, propel it out, we start coughing. And it comes out from our nose. It comes out from our mouth. Okay, it's a reflex action. Immediately. So the movement of the epiglottis is going to be immediately coming into action if there is any mixing of food and wind. Fine. Such a beautiful mechanism we have got. See. So any doubts with these three structures: internal nares, pharynx, laryngopharynx. किसी को कोई doubt है बेटा? Got it now? Okay. Then we come to larynx. It's also called as voice box, or it's called as Adam's apple, or it is called as Pumas Adami. Okay, No, that is the system I'm talking about. I'm not saying that the food when it comes out of our nose or mouth is beautiful. I'm saying look at the system, how beautifully it has been, placed. Any garbage, and then you will feel the difference. So the system is beautiful. Larynx, it's also called as voice box or Adam's apple or pomazidami. After puberty, it gets more developed in males in comparison to females. Because of this very reasons, males have got a deeper voice. So, after puberty, immediately you can figure out on the phone also if it's a female who is talking to you or a male who is talking to you. Okay, so this is just because of the development of this larynx, voice box. It is supported by four cartilages, which prevents its collapsing. And these cartilages का नाम नीचे दिया है देखो, thyroid. There's one cartilage called as thyroid. Can you all see thyroid cartilage? Ye dekho, this is the thyroid cartilage, this blue part. Okay, it's the largest thyroid cartilage. Second is cricoid. Okay, so you can see over here, below the thyroid, this is going to be the cricoid cartilage. Ye dekho, this is the cricoid cartilage. Then you have got artenoid cartilage. Artenoid cartilage, you can see this. Just like a vacuum pump or a funnel. You can see this funnel shaped structure. This is your artenoid cartilage. Okay. And cartilage of Santroni. So cartilage of Santroni is actually, it's going to be on the anterior posterior diana. Yeah, it's going to be on the anterior side. Okay. Is artenoid cartilage hollow? All are hollow. All are one. Okay. What exactly happens to the voice of the males? How do they go deep? It's because of the hormones. The hormones are going to pull the vocal cords in different way for males and differently for females. So the way the hormones will be pulling the vocal cords in a particular position, accordingly the voice will become deeper. Okay. Fine. Yeah, it's just like tuning your guitar or your sitar or any string instruments, na. Like when you tune, I don't know if you all have ever seen the guitar or sitar or something like that way. So what happens is, the keys are going to be present to tighten or loosen the strings. So the way you're going to tighten or loosen the strings accordingly, the sound will be heard in that particular way. Everything is same. Your also. Males have thicker cords than females. Yeah, actually. Okay. Well, so you all understood the cartilages, huh? आगे भी है जो मैं इंडिविजुअली इसको समझा रही हूँ, तो इट विल बी सिंपल. थायराइड कार्टिलेज, वन सिंगल कार्टिलेज, व्हिच इज ऑफ हाइलिन टाइप. हाइलिन मींस ग्लास लाइक. ओके, इट इज लार्जेस्ट साइज शी शेप कार्टिलेज व्हिच सपोर्ट्स एंटीरियर एज वेल एज द लैटरल साइड्स of the upper part of the larynx. Cricoid cartilage, again one in number. It is somewhat smaller, thicker, and complete ring or collar-like cartilage around the larynx behind the thyroid cartilage. So here you saw now, this was your thyroid cartilage. And this is C-shaped, means it is not entire. Ye dekho, idhar khatam ho raha hai. This is entire. It's like a collar. So it's going to fit like this way over the entire larynx. Sagittal section means cross section. It's going to be seen as a cross section. Okay. Then artenoid cartilage. These are two pyramids, two in number. We have seen already. Pyramid shaped cartilage is funnel ke jaise. It is smallest cartilage which supports posterior wall of the upper part of the larynx. And cartilage of Santroni. Each artenoid terminates in front of five swollen knobs called as the cartilage of Santroni. It's made up of elastic cartilage. So, each artenoid terminates, na, isliye ye bhi do hai, dekho. These are also two. These are also two. Okay. So, they are, going to be placed somewhat in this particular position here. Swollen knobs, knob-like thing. Okay. So in this way, these are the four types of cartilages. Then we come to the vocal cords. as we were talking just now, now here are some important and funny and interesting facts also I'm going to share with you all. See, in larynx, two pairs of vocal cord is found. Outer pair is called as false vocal cord, whereas inner pair is called as true vocal cord. When air is forced through the larynx, it causes vibrations of the true vocal cords and sound is produced. So in this case, what's going to happen, beta? There are two pairs, false and true. So when we breathe in, only then we can talk. Don't breathe and try to talk. It will be very difficult. It will be suffocating, right? So when we breathe in, the air is going to actually vibrate the true vocal cords, okay? And it will cause vibrations in the vocal cords that will produce the sound. The pitch of the sound is determined by the tension of the vocal cords. The greater the tension, the higher the pitch. Higher pitch means female ka pitch. Females have got high-pitched sound. High-pitched means thin sound. Thin hota hai. Ladies ki jo awaaz hoti hai, bahut thin, patli hoti hai awaaz. Gents ki awaaz thick hoti hai. Hai ya nahi? So that is what is about the, you know, how they are tuned in. Just like a guitar or a sitar, I told you just now. Yeah, but sometimes, you know, like that thick voice, hai na, it can be tolerated. But female voice continuously aata hai na, to bombarding lagta hai. Nahi lagta hai tumhe? Don't you all feel this? Come on. Give credit to your mamas. Nahi? My son will agree to it if I tell him. He'll say, yeah, yeah, that is true. Continuous cha, 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 cha. Hey, I'm going to do it now. Why are you behind me? I'll do it now. I said I'll do it, so I'll do it. Don't be behind me. But I think all females have got high pitch and continuous bache log ke peeche padne ki aadat. Do this, come on, do this, come on, do this. I can't help you. I mean, it's a part of our life. It's irritating, na? I know. Railway announcement is also done by females. Yeah, yeah, I know. Like sometimes, you know, like when I talk, when I, you know, actually talk with you all or, you know, with my students generally, I sometimes wonder, see, in physics and chemistry and maths and all, na, it's like the teacher speak, then they give you to solve something. Hai na? वो तुम्हें सॉल्विंग के लिए दे देते हैं फिर चुप बैठते हैं तो उतना टाइम तो तुम्हारा दिमाग शांत रहेगा. बायो में ऐसा नहीं होता है ना. बायो में कंटिन्यूअस इधर आई विल टॉक और यू विल टॉक. करेक्ट ना. आई नो दिस. तो समटाइम्स इवन आई फील दैट आई होप दैट माय वोकल कॉर्ड्स आर नॉट गेटिंग एक्स्ट्रा स्ट्रेच्ड एंड टेंस्ड सो दैट यू फील लाइक ओ माय गॉड ये कितना बोल रही है. So, इसीलिए मैं कभी कभी दो मिनट चुपचाप हो जाती हूँ. देखो देखो कुछ डाउट है तो पानी भी पी लेती हूँ और थोड़ा शांति मिल जाएगा यार एक मिनट है ना विद दिस हाई पिच्ड वॉइस ऑफ माइन. सो आई मीन आई समटाइम्स फील लाइक दैट वे यू नो एट द एंड ऑफ द डे इफ आई एम टेकिंग लेक्चर्स नाउ सिंस मॉर्निंग 7:30 से मेरे लेक्चर स्टार्ट हो जाते हैं टिल इवनिंग अराउंड 6:37 मेरा चलता ही रहता है बैक टू बैक कंटिन्यूअस होता ही रहता है कुछ ना कुछ. सो एट द एंड ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर सेशन ना आई जस्ट सिट क्वाइटली फॉर माई सेल्फ आई से कितना बोलती है कंटिन्यूअसली मुझे ही मेरी आवाज है ना कभी कभी इरिटेटिंग हो जाती है. सो आपकी हालत क्या होती होगी यार. But can't help na. We have to learn all these things. So basically, yeah, this is what I'm talking about. That females have got a higher pitch voice and males have got a low pitch voice. Same condition, I know. In terms of singing, I can't sing high pitch. Oh. Exactly, na it happens, na even I feel like that way. But see, I'm very talkative. Krishna. Well, anyway, so till today, you are living a peaceful life, I should say, na, huh? Well. That's good. Okay, beta. So you know what? This is about the true vocal cords and the false vocal cords. Then what is the reason for the false vocal cords to be present? Why they are required? अगर true vocal cords जो है वही अगर काम में आते हैं तो why you require the false vocal cords? ऐसे ही time pass. Last 2 years is horrendous. It's for all of us, Ray. It's for all of us. What my life is worst? No one's life is worst. Huh? To make other noises, the false vocal cords. No. What happens is, see, whenever you have to tighten the string, you have to have additional extra support to either make it tight or to make it loose. For how many years you are teaching? 21 years. Last 21 years I'm teaching. So, last 21 years I am feeling, am I irritating my dear students? I know. You all are not even born that time, my dears. Before that, so many years before that. I'm small and I'm fully stressed. Ah, that's fine. Okay, so I was talking about the importance of the false vocal cords, my dears. So the false vocal cords are going to be present for either tightening or losing that true vocal cords. Okay, so even they are required. So we can't neglect them. Hey, why you want that? When I'll meet you, I'll tell you in person. Vidhi, I'll tell you in person. I won't disclose it now. You don't get bored to teach same thing so many times. Aray, I enjoy with, you know, every time I teach the same chapter, I enjoy every time. I really like that. Because, you know, I know, but I also know that you all don't know, na. So to tell something new for you all, it's going to be something new. So with the same enthu, I always, you know, get back to work. I enjoy teaching. Basically, I enjoy teaching a lot. That is good. That is good, Shweta. That is better. Exactly. You also get different comments from different students, and that makes go in a very positive way. Like when I see your interactions, when I see your comments, and when I get something that you all are now interested because of so and so things and all, then that makes me, you know, all the more come out with all my enthu in me, and that makes me teach you to the best. yes. I know that is a task, na. No, but that teacher in me has taught me to manage both. Okay. Come on. See, next line is also very important, huh? No, not at all. See, vocal cords are modified mucus folds of larynx. So what are vocal cords? They are nothing. They are fold, modified mucus ke folds hai wo. And that is giving us all the sound that we are producing, right? False ones are like, you know, those extra things which are coming out of the keys. And true ones are the strings. Okay? Now, see over here. Look at this note. A very beautiful and very funny also. See, sounds get converted into speech by tongue. Okay? Movement of tongue is controlled by the speech center of the brain. Function of vocal cord is to help in tightening the true vocal cords. Okay, to make it tighter. So I'll be teaching you neural control and coordination. Na? That time I'll show you. I have got the model of the brain with me. POP ka hai. Original brain leke koi ghoomta nahi hai. Nahi to tumhe lagega main exactly kya kya karti hu. I mean, I'm not at all involved in any of the black magics. Huh? Please. Wo jo brain hai na, wo किसका है? पीओपी का है, फाइबर का है. ओके, सो आई गेट दैट एंड आई विल शो यू दैट हाउ इट इज ऑल टुगेदर, यू नो. सो दैट टाइम यू विल कम टू नो दैट देयर आर सर्टेन एरियाज. So we have got areas that is called a speech center in a particular area in our brain, which will modulate our speech. So see, when you speak, you sometimes, you mix two, three languages and you speak sometimes. Like even I do this, right? Now, even when I'm explaining, in between I bring Hindi or, one or two words to make you all understand about Marathi or Gujarati or something like that way. So how is that possible? So it is because of the speech centers, which are helping me to move the tongue in that correct way so that you all understand my language. Okay. So yes, this is going to be there in the speech center. So the tongue is going to help in, speech, right? Not in voice, in speech. Speech center is not developed very well in dumb persons. Dumb means the ones who cannot speak, na? I don't know if you have seen, like small children, especially, na? When they can't speak, they have got those typical, ek unki alag language padhai jati hai, right? So they don't have the speech center developed. Otherwise, their tongue is developed. Their voice, vocal cords are developed. But because the speech center isn't developed, na, they are not able to speak, right? When we switch between the language, we unconsciously switch personality. Nothing. It's like just the ease of making your point across to the second person for that person to understand what is your ideology. We switch over, right? Voice of rabbit is called as quaking. False vocal cords remain absent in elephants. Elephants do not have false vocal cord. So they cannot, modulate their voices. See, for example, right now I'm teaching you, I'm having my normal pitch. But if I have to sing, then my pitch would change. Correct? Right? So I can adjust those because of the presence of the false. But in case of elephants, they do not have false vocal cords. Okay? True vocal cords remain absent in hippopotamus. So they are not able to make any sound. Okay? And voice apparatus of birds is called as strings. I don't know if you have heard about this. Sirens bhi kehte hai kuch log. Sirens or sings, it's going to be the same. So that sirens is going to be, giving that typical choppy sound that you hear of the birds. Okay. Quacking was supposed to be. Duck quakes, of course, but even rabbit ka vocal cord jo hai na, voice form, quacking kehte. Elephants are bad singers, probably. Dogs have false, they do have. So they are going to make different sounds. Dogs' ke sounds alag-alag level ke hote hai. Haan ya na? Even if they bark, they can bark normally, loudly and very loudly also. Okay? So that's about the vocal cords. Right? Well, then we have got the no one ever speak in life. No, beta. Their speech center mein gadbad hai na? So then they will have to have their brain ka region corrected, which is a difficulty. So they can't. Okay. Eighth organ is trachea, which is called as the windpipe. Huh. Speech therapy, they are going to be made, their tongue movements are going to be controlled actually. Their tongue movements will be controlled. I don't know about tortoises. I've never heard about it. So I won't, tell you something, yes or no. You all check. But elephant, ka mujhe pata hai. Okay. Trachea is a long tubular structure which runs downwards through the neck in front of the esophagus. So esophagus is going to be at the back side and trachea is going to be towards the front side. Okay. It is supported by 16 to 20 dorsally. Dorsally means piche se. Okay. Incomplete C-shaped cartilaginous rings called as the tracheal rings, which prevents it from collapsing. So just like how we have, agar ghar mein koi wire laga hua hai na, to open na, matlab wall ke andar wala nahi, conceal wiring nahi. Bahar ka wiring hota hai, to have you all seen, we put the C-shaped clips over it, so it doesn't come out, it doesn't fall down. In the same way, even our trachea will have these cartilaginous C-shaped rings, so that it doesn't, you know, get dislocated. Fine. It is lined by pseudostratified ciliated epithelium with mucus secreting goblet cells. So this is very important. The trachea is going to be having pseudostratified. So you already know what is pseudostratified. Ciliated means they'll have a number of cilia present on its surface. Okay. With mucus secreting goblet cells. So it's also to have, you know, certain cells called as the goblet cells, which are involved in making mucus. Fine. So mucus ko hai na, agar mucus zyada secrete ho gaya na, then we call it as cough. So sometimes when we cough na, to ek sticky exudate bahar nikal aata hai. Sometimes, you know, it's slimy. Of course, mucus is slimy. So while coughing, sometimes, you know, you spit out that cough from your, you know, tracheal region. Yeah. Exactly. Is it ciliated? For removing the dust particles and the microbes away. They don't want them to enter inside the lungs. So it's going to be ciliated for sweeping action. Cilia is going to help in sweeping action. Okay, jhaadu maarte hai na vaise. Yeah, that is very bad na. So we are always taught from our childhood days that when you cough, you have to put your hand in front of your mouth, even while sneezing. Nowadays, so sneezing is done like this way. They don't want to bring their hands also, right? So when you collect your sneeze in this particular arm, na, you're going to be saving yourself and others also from contracting any airborne diseases. Yeah, crook of our arm. Yes. Nowadays, it's like after corona, everyone has started sneezing like this way, right? Okay. So you understood what are goblet cells? So goblet cells are those which are going to secrete mucus. Mucus is nothing but it's a slimy layer which will trap the bacteria, viruses, and dust particles and prevent it from entering our lungs. Okay, so mucus secretion is very important. After trachea comes the primary bronchi. So here in the diagram, you can very well see. Can you all see this primary bronchi? Here they go. This is a part of your trachea, which is split into two parts. Can you see? So this is also going to be your, this is your left primary bronchus. This is your right primary bronchus. This one. First division. These are a pair of small, thin-walled tubular structures formed by the division of trachea at the level of fifth thoracic vertebrae near the heart. So we have got, you know, backside, maybe we have got the vertebral column. So the vertebral column, which is going to be present in the thoracic region. Thoracic region means not in the front, at the back only, beta, but uske aage thorax aa jata hai. So ye jo area hai humare vertebral column ka, jo thorax ke idhar aa jata hai, usko hum kehte hai thoracic vertebrae. And when you count it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So fifth thoracic vertebrae jahan aata hai na, uske yahan par this particular one are going to be branched out. So it's a position which is fixed in all of us, okay? Near the heart. The right bronchus, here you can see this right bronchus, this is the right bronchus, is wider and shorter and more vertically placed than the left bronchus. So here, this is going to be wider is what it is said. Of course, not seen in this diagram very clearly, but this is going to be the wider one. Like trachea, primary bronchi is supported by cartilaginous rings. Each primary bronchus enters the lung of its own side. So right will enter the right lung. You can see over here. The left will enter the left lung. Okay. Vertically placed for proper efficiency, for proper filling up of the lungs. If they are not going to be placed vertically, even if they tilt a bit, na, to filling of air pura nahi ho jayega achi tarah se. So to fill up the air to its maximum capacity in the lungs, unka placement vertical hona zaruri hai. Right now? Correct? You take a pen and you try to put ink inside it by holding it upright. It will get completely filled. You tilt it, there's going to be a column left without the ink. So when it's going to be placed perfectly vertical, it will be filled to its maximum capacity. Okay? Got it? Yeah. So here you can see, this is going to be the lungs. Right lobe is divided into, you know, three parts. See, superior lobe, middle lobe and inferior lobe. Three parts में right lung divide होता है, जबकि left lung जो है सिर्फ two parts में होता है, superior and inferior, right? The reason is it has to fit the heart in between. तो left side में heart fit करना है, इसीलिए. Okay? Well, so now you all can see over here. That is going to be the bronchial tree. Bronchial tree, also called as BT, and respiratory tree called as RT. My dears, please understand this. Huh? This is a very common thing which is asked in this chapter. And many of the times people make blunders in this. So please understand what is BT and what is RT. Huh? Simple hai, bahut easy hai, but please pay attention. When trachea enters into the thoracic cavity, it divides into two branches called as primary bronchus. So here you can see here, this is the trachea. It is dividing into two called as the primary bronchi. Okay. Branches of primary bronchus up to the terminal bronchus, bronchioles makes up the bronchial tree. So here you can see, this is then secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi, and here there will be the terminal bronchi, okay, which is going to be called as bronchioles, fine? So these are the terminal. So if you see, this is the end. Terminal means end part, okay? Terminal bronchial tree. Terminal bronchioles divide to form respiratory bronchioles and branches. So this is going to be your respiratory bronchioles. Can you see this here? ये ऐसे folded things दिखाई देते हैं ना, जितने भी these all folded ones, serrated margins वाले ना, these are going to be your respiratory bronchioles. Okay, so the terminal bronchioles will divide to form respiratory bronchioles. Fine. Then see what happens in respiratory bronchioles and branches of respiratory bronchioles makes up the respiratory tree. So from here up till here, it's going to be the respiratory tree. Gaseous exchange occurs in the respiratory tree while there is no gaseous exchange taking place in the bronchial tree. So bronchial tree mein kuch exchange nahi hoga. It will only act as a passage. It will only act as a pathway for the transport of the gases. But actual exchange of gases will begin only in the respiratory tree. Is it fine? Understood? Now, volume of air which is filled in the bronchial tree is a part of dead space volume. Can you see this? Dead space volume. Dead space because there is no exchange of gases. It doesn't mean that there is nothing over here. There is air filled in this. Air is there, but it is not exchanged. So we call it as dead space. Okay, which does not take part in gaseous exchange. So yahan par bahut gadbad karte hai beta log. Whenever it's asked na, whenever it is asked about the dead space na, people will say there is nothing, therefore it is dead. No, there is no exchange of gases taking place, therefore it is dead. Air is there. Air is there everywhere. Yahan par sab jagah par air hai. But exchange nahi ho raha hai na air, therefore we call it as dead space. And the minute that respiratory bronchioles will be formed, now this is your transition or respiratory zone where actual exchange of gases would take place. Theek hai? Got this? So any difficulty in understanding this part, my dears? Anyone who has got difficulty in understanding this? BT and RT? And what is dead space? Very important part. Clear, clear? All of you? Is it clear for all of you? Okay, fine. That's what I said. It's easy, but you have to, you know, understand that. Just to sum up the things. So just to sum up the things, my dears, that is what nostril, nasal cavity. Okay, below the nostril lies the nasal cavity. Nasal cavity will have hair, mucous membrane, sinus openings, olfactory bulbs, nasal septum, which will lead to nasopharynx. Okay. Nasopharynx will have pharyngeal tonsils and eustachian tubes. Pharyngeal tonsils are your tonsils. Dukhte hai na kabhi kabhi. It pains. Some people have got this tonsils ka issue, pata hai aapko? Haan. So that is this, which is going to be present in the nasopharyngeal region. Eustachian tube is the one which is connected with our ear for maintaining our balance. Kabhi kabhi, I don't know, aapke saath aisa hua hai ya nahi hua hai. But sometimes you are sitting doing nothing or phir you are sleeping. Okay, and you will feel that you're falling down. Huh? Have you all had this sensation of falling down in sleep? Yeah, that is because of pressure difference in the eustachian tube. So it happens. Okay. Tonsils are your lymph nodes basically, which are going to be responsible for acting like barriers for bacterial infections and all. Viral infection, bacterial infection ko prevent karne ke liye, they secrete mucus. That is tonsils. Okay. Yeah, sometimes they overgrow. Yeah. Then you need to cut them. Nowadays we don't. Oh my God. So that is your nasopharynx. From nasopharynx, we come to oropharynx. So we know naso ke niche oropharynx hai, which is going to have palatine tonsils, tongue, oral cavity, and uvula. You will learn about all these things in chapter of digestion. Okay. Then from oropharynx, we go to laryngopharynx. See, everything cannot be fit one below the other in this on the screen. So nostril to nasal cavity, nasal cavity to nasopharynx, nasopharynx to oropharynx, oropharynx to laryngopharynx, laryngopharynx to larynx. Okay. Larynx to trachea via the vocal cords. Trachea to primary bronchi, secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi, quaternary bronchi, bronchioles, and finally we come to alveoli. So wherever they have given in blue, respiratory tract structures passed through, and green, accessory structures passed by. So the air will pass via the nostril, through the nasal cavity, through the nasopharynx, and so on. Okay. And these are going to be passed by, means they are the ones who are going to be coming in between, who will be passing from the nasal to nasopharynx. Okay. So your the entire ideology is very, very clear. Nostril to alveoli, how is the journey? All that we have done till now. Any problem in understanding this? Any difficulty in understanding this, beta? Go through it patafat. ml fixed for everyone. No, it is fixed. It is fixed. Dead space is fixed. 150 ml is a dead space in all of us. Lingual tonsils, the one which are going to be present near the tongue region. Okay. There are three types of tonsils as you can see. Okay. Nth part is the lung. So we had to do joint portion of the tongue with the jaw. Joint portion, the one connects the tongue with the jaw, uvula. That flap that you can see, you can touch it. So out of the 10 structures or organs that we had to study about the respiratory system, we have completed 9 organs till now. The last one is the 10th organ, which is lungs. And lungs, I won't, start today because it needs to be done in detail. So for today, I'll stop. And on Friday, we'll move ahead with understanding lungs as well as the physiology of breathing. Okay, because we have almost completed the organs, right from the nostrils up till our, bronchi and bronchioles. So on Friday, we'll go ahead with lungs and I'll talk about more details about the internal structure of the lungs as well. Fine. Chalo, my dears. So see you on Friday. Connect karta hai beta. Wo bola connect karta hai tongue and apne niche wale palate ko. Okay. Yeah. Chalo. Bye-bye. See you all. See you all. Not at all, my dear. Not at all. Not at all. Not at all. Okay. Bye, 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 Meg. Bye. Don't worry. It's okay. Bye, see you all.